As you work with loops and audio files in Pro Tools SE, you may find it necessary to correct the timing of a passage or apply a certain feel to one or more audio loops. So here we are back in our session, and I've already added a drum loop to the MIDI tracks that I recorded. Now I'm going to add another loop to go along with this one. And again, I'm just going to dig down into the factory folder and find something that I think fits with what I've got going on already. Now I like the sound of this one, I think it works, and as I drag it in, I can't drop it on a mono track because the loop is stereo, and because I don't have another stereo track, I can simply drop it in an empty portion of the track list. Pro Tools will create the track for me. Just going to move it up to my other loop. Nice. If I want that loop to continue through the rest of my arrangement, I can choose the trimmer tool, and instead of clicking in the bottom half of the region, click in the top half. That will be the loop trimmer. Now you can extend it a little bit or all the way to the end. Now I want to go ahead and fix the lazy timing of my original drum loop just here. I'm going to solo the piano and the drums so that we can hear what's going on. Just going to choose my selector tool and we'll play it from here. Okay, so the slop is just here. I'm going to switch on warp view. That way I can manipulate any of the transients in my drum passage. Let's zoom in and take another listen. Okay, so right here, going to press the escape key to select my hand tool, and then as you hover over the vertical lines, you can add a warp marker, which will then snap to the grid. We'll do another one, and one more. Now you can also move transients in free time, just turn snapping off, and then move as you please. Amazing. Turn snapping back on and put this in its proper place. Then just go along and fix all the other transients until you're happy with your edits. I'm going to use the scroll wheel to get to the last one. There we go. Zoom out, control left bracket, and then escape key to select my selector tool or marquee, click and hit play. Now I can quantize or change the entire feel of a selection. Check it out. Just enable warp view for the track and then make a selection, like this. And from the edit menu under region notes, choose snap to grid. Here we can set the grid value, 16th notes, and change the amount of swing that we apply to the quantize. Click OK to apply those settings. Nice. Now I'm going to apply the same quantize to the first part of the drums prior to the drum fill. I'll leave the fill itself unswung. Again, from the edit menu, choose snap to grid and then just apply the same settings. I can even apply the same thing to a MIDI region. Just right-click on the MIDI region itself and choose the same option. And now it's in the pocket. Now I'm going to take solo off and mute the bass line. I'm going to be recording some real bass in another video. Now because I finished editing the loops, I'm going to go back to my regular waveform view.